Brian Whelan has already started his research after finding out that missiles could be set up virtually above his head during the Olympics. The first he knew about the plans was when a leaflet came through the door.
At first I thought maybe it was a prank. I had a look at it. It looked genuine, very angry. I'd previously seen soldiers in uniform bringing crates into the tower. Was quite shocked when I saw that. So it clicked, you know, when we got this, that it was legitimate.
Sent out by the Ministry of Defence, it describes how their Olympic plans may include using ground-based air defence systems, part of which would be based on top of Lexington Building Water Tower. They explain how a high-velocity missile system may be situated on the roof, adding that the building was chosen because of the excellent view across the local area, including the Olympic Park. The leaflet covers a number of questions that residents might have. For example, are there no other suitable buildings nearby? How can we be sure that this is safe? And also, interestingly, will having missiles on our building make us a target? The answer to that one is a very clear no. They say that actually the presence will improve local security and will not make this building a target for terrorists. The MOD say that using missiles on top of the tower at Bow Quarter would be a last resort, but they did announce before Christmas that they could form part of the Olympic security plan.
These measures are absolutely necessary, though protective, and it's all about deterrence and control of the airspace. The government has an obligation to the International Olympic Committee to protect over 100 heads of state who are visiting and all the athletes that come from all over the world.
Brian's been staggered at the reaction he's had, some saying his remarks are irresponsible.
I think the irresponsible people here are the Ministry of Defence, who are putting missiles on top of civilian location, didn't consult anyone, and then surprise, wake up to find out, you know, that the army are here to stay for 2 months.
In early May, the armed forces and police will carry out exercises in preparations for the Games. After that, they'll decide if the missiles are needed. Brian, however, has already made up his mind. Rhiannon Mills, Sky News.